Dreams come in many forms. This is the dream of college lacrosse. I came from the mud. In the city of brotherly love, it only makes sense that this team is focused on family.
My name is Piper Bond. I'm a senior. Crazy. Coach Murph came down to Baltimore and he's like, hey, you get you a spot on the team. It's a really good school, good program.
The reason I came here was just because of the people I met, all the players on the team, like, there wasn't one person who didn't love being a part of Penn Lacrosse and love every part of Penn Lacrosse.
Starting off with Philadelphia, it's a great city. If you love sports and passionate fans and passionate people, it's a great place to be. And I think just coming here socially, there's great people, there's intelligent people, there's leaders of different cultures and backgrounds that you get to go to school with every day.
I just felt like I belonged here the minute I stepped on this campus, and it just felt right for a whole lot of reasons, lacrosse being part of that, but the city campus, the diversity of a place like Penn, the challenges of a place like Penn, and the strong sense of community that you feel when you're sitting here in West Philadelphia.
All right, really working our step posture, talking about that dodge, snap back inside. Let's get a good slide.
Ever since I was a little kid, I dreamed of playing lacrosse at the highest level. Dream of yourself scoring the game-winning goal or just being able to put that all together and work hard enough to get to this level. It's just definitely a dream come true.
One of the senior captains at one of the Ivy League schools that I was visiting said to me, you need to go where it feels like home. And I get chills because my next visit was to Philadelphia. And I went around and met the guys on Penn Lacrosse, and it was home. Penn Lacrosse has won Ivy League championships, is in one of the most vibrant cities in the country, and is a top university in the world. After 2 years sidelined, the expectations of Penn Lacrosse have never been higher.
James Shipley hits the shot to send us into overtime with 1 second left. And Jack Schultz just comes out of the box, darts down and stings one top right. It was pretty awesome.
We've had a lot of ups and downs this year. I mean, we were really confident going into the season, and then we've lost a couple games that we shouldn't have lost.
Penn Lacrosse endured overtime losses to Princeton and Yale.
Because when we lose and you see everyone's face after, it burns me up to see my teammates upset. Like, what, you know, I gotta do more, you know, I gotta find a way to get us so we don't look like this after.
After losing to Yale in the quarterfinals of the NCAA tournament, that one stings, and I think everybody, I can speak for everybody in my class, when we remember that feeling, and we're coming back with a vengeance this year after grinding out two COVID years of no games and captain-led practices and player-led practices by ourselves out here on the field with no lights on, no cameras out here watching us just grinding.
So we had a players only meeting last week after we lost to Brown, and we came together and we're like, all right, man, we gotta air this out. Like, if there's anything that we think is limiting us from, you know, winning these close games, and we aired everything out, and we kind of came together after that. We all brought it in, you know, in our house. We're like all in on, you know, just, I've never been a part of something like that.
We're battling some really hard teams. The league's super strong this year, and we're just really, really geared up and ready to go for the postseason.
With the Ivy League never being more competitive than this season, there are currently 5 Ivy League teams in the top 10 of NCAA. And facing 4-4, Penn Lacrosse's season and dream aspirations come down to the game against Harvard.
If we lose to Harvard, our season's basically over. If we don't come out and compete on that field, really battle for all 60 minutes, so then we run the risk of not being able to play it again. Our backs were against the wall a little bit, and that's kind of the mentality we took going into the game. Like, it's ride or die here, and we gotta lock in, focus up, and get the job done. And that's been our mentality: accomplish the mission.
When you're dreaming of college lacrosse, you're not really thinking of the early morning grind. It's something that you kind of realize once you get here. It's a little more than you thought maybe in your dream. But in reality, once it gets to game day, it really becomes that dream. You get to be on the field in front of thousands of fans in an amazing place like Franklin Field.
Coach Murphy really made it a point that Harvard was a must win.
And it's that accountability, telling guys what they need to hear and not necessarily what they want to hear. And that's, you know, the culture that Coach Murphy's put in here.
Do you like your job?
I love my job. I can't believe I get paid to do this still.
Coach Murphy he's got a lot of different personalities, I think, for different situations. He can be really intense. He can be, you know, your best friend. He can be a hard ass, let you know when, you know, give you a little kick when you need it.
He's a tough guy when he needs to be. He lets you know. He's going to keep it honest with you, and he's always got your back. That's what it is, you know. He's a good coach. He's going to do whatever it takes for the team, and that's why you trust him.
Coach Murphy cares a lot about his players. Obviously, he's a really tactical lacrosse coach. He knows everything, every aspect of the game, how to make people better, how to push people to kind of get the best out of everyone.
He forms a relationship with every kid on the team, top of the depth chart or the bottom of the depth chart. He's a really funny guy, and he gets us on an interpersonal level.
He's just like, you know, the greatest mentor you could ask for.
He makes you feel comfortable enough to be able to go talk to him about anything, whether that's your life, your family, schoolwork, or lacrosse. Like, he's just like a father figure to a lot of the guys on the team.
Coach Murphy has done a great job, turned this into a program that competes at a national championship level every year.
Just the satisfaction of watching a kid come in here and you know, just be at a certain level of maturity at age 17 or 18, and then watch them go through the process and all that we do, and then leave here and ready to go out into the world and be successful and contribute and make the world a better place. It's exhilarating.
I think Murph would be proud of me for saying this, but you know, the goal is for every person who's a part of this program to leave a better man than when they first got here.
Let's go, let's go!
With top recruits coming from states across America, Penn Lacrosse has prided itself on building a foundation of family with the seniors through freshmen.
The guys in this room and the guys that have graduated already, like, these are our best friends. And so we're down here all the time. You know, yes, we're getting better, you know, we're playing lacrosse doing that, but like, we're just hanging out. We're watching TV, watching sports, you know, playing our little games in here and stuff like that, so.
I didn't know it was gonna be this much fun.
It's challenging, but you know, we rely on each other. We take classes together, we support each other. Below a 3.0, you're gonna be in study hall until you get out, and we don't have anyone in study hall.
I'm only a freshman, and I was a little nervous coming in here, but you feel like your best friends after 2 days.
You are going to be brought into this family and shown the ropes, and you know there's definitely some ups and downs, and you got to earn your spot, but we love you no matter what.
Personally, this year I made it my goal to have a one-on-one personal relationship outside of lacrosse with every person in our locker room and on the team.
It starts with the little things, you know, when you come to the locker room at 7 a.m. for a 7 a.m. lift and an older senior asks just how you're doing, you know, and then on the field it looks like just a hug after a goal or a high five after a goal or a nice play here and there.
This is basically a family, you know. It's like, you know, these guys are tight and they're part of something.
You know, every single guy on the team is just someone you love and someone you really care about.
This is my room right here.
Is it fun?
Yeah, Penn's a blast. It really is a work hard, play hard.
Two calls that we have at the huddles are, when we break down, are all in and family.
You know, that sort of brotherhood, sisterhood sort of thing where no matter who you are, what you do for a living, or it's about the team.
And we, you know, we do really enjoy each other here. Like, we don't just say that, like, we mean it.
You're walking into 50 guys who are already your best friends. And, you know, it's just a group of guys working towards a collective goal to win an Ivy League and national championship.
You want to be around a group of 50 amazing guys, Penn's a good choice.
The last 2.5 years I've been a part of it has been like probably the best 2.5 years of my life.
No question, these guys are gonna be with me for the rest of my life, and I wouldn't have it any other way.
You know, I think a Penn lacrosse player is someone who is willing to giving back to the community of Philadelphia with 40 other guys. That's it. It's really just willing to give up a part of yourself.
I love Young Quakes. It's like one of my favorite things to do.
Yeah, so Young Quakers is our community outreach program. We help West Philadelphia-based schools. You know, we're all fortunate to have lacrosse in our lives, and we want to spread that to other people and other kids.
As a only black male on our team, you know, that's something I take pride in, seeing kids come in and trying to make a difference and stuff like that. I want to make a difference in these kids' life.
Going to the Young Quake session and have these fifth and sixth graders from West Philly, like, remember my name. Penn Lacrosse is a place of opportunity, and that's an opportunity to get involved in your community. And, you know, Young Quakes is one of the brightest parts of my week every week, I think.
So we shaved our heads. There was about 30 of us who did it as a fundraiser for cancer.
We do this thing with a foundation. They honor every head shaved with $1,000 donated to childhood cancer research.
And jobs and things like that too. I mean, the connections that we make here are pretty sweet.
With generations of incredible lacrosse and successful businessmen, the alumni network of Penn Lacrosse is one of the strongest in the world.
To go to such a, you know, great academic institution, the opportunity of finding a great job that perfectly fits you. And Coach Murph always said that being a part of Penn Lacrosse is a 40-year decision, not a 4-year decision.
This place kind of unboxes it a little bit because it's time to figure it out a little bit for yourself.
It's awesome. Everyone pushes you to become a better athlete and a better person.
Going through what you have to go through to call yourself a Penn Lacrosse player, it makes you prepared for a lot of the different challenges that are going to come at you in life, in career, in personal relationships.
In the last 2 years, when Penn Lacrosse was ineligible, their family suffered a tragedy. Penn Lacrosse alum James Farrell and his brother Michael were in a car accident where they both died. The Penn Lacrosse team has rallied to dedicate their season to number 19.
So the shirt I'm wearing commemorates the first annual Farrell Cup, which is a cup to remember both James and Michael Farrell. In remembrance of them and in honor of them, and hopefully each year we continue to do that on a regular basis.
The dream of college lacrosse is to win championships, and with their entire season in the balance, Penn Lacrosse knows that it all comes down to today.
Today we have about, I think, 100 to 200 alumni packed into a white tent ready to cheer the boys on and have a good day, so I'm very excited.
Power play as here's Fury again, kicks across, fires and scores! Gabe Fury with a rocket for his sixth of the year. We're tied at one. Draws a triple team, finds the open man, finally gets free here, Handley scores! Looks in, fires and it goes in. Three for set, and they score. Owen Gaffney with his 10th of the year.
Heading into halftime, Harvard leads 4-3. And after 3 years in the making, Penn Lacrosse is now do or die for their season.
Because we're going to be good no matter what. We just got to trust each other.
Back up top. Shot comes in. Scores!
What was a season is now down to 30 minutes.
Bedard gets free, throws up, one shot, score! Beautiful quick stick goal!
We showed in that second half especially that we're resilient. Once we really get our groove going like that, that we can play with and beat anybody.
Then skip the cross, shot comes in, scores! An absolute rocket from Dylan Gagar! He gets the hat trick, and it's now 8-4 Quakers! From 70 yards out, and it's now 11-7 Quakers!
On the Harvard game, we had a pretty special event with all the alumni there. They were all on the sideline. After we got that win and secured the W, we all got together as a team after we shook Harvard's hands and we sprinted over the alumni to celebrate, which is the greatest feeling there.
When you look at what those guys have done and how they're coming back this year, it just makes you feel like this culture is very real, right? Struggled through COVID, we lost a whole season, we lost a few players, and here they are, right back at it. and I think that is so Penn Lacrosse. It's amazing.
And now it's just about stacking wins. It's a one-game season for the rest of the year. We lose, we're probably done.
After beating Harvard, Penn Lacrosse advanced to the Ivy League tournament as a number 4 seed, getting redemption against Brown and beating Yale to win their back-to-back Ivy League championship.
Growing up, I wanted to play for some different teams, and now I'm at Penn and we're playing against those teams and we're beating those teams. I'm looking back and I'm like, you know, I'm so glad this is where I am. There's nowhere else I'd rather be.
If we really just buy in and want it, coach has been talking about it, we're gonna win most games.
When I say I dream of college lacrosse, my dreams don't even hold a light to my experience here. It's everything and more.
When I look back at my life, you know, I've made some of the best friends I've ever had in my life here. I met my wife here in West Philadelphia. You know, I came here a boy and left coming a man.
I can't even really put it into words. Just if any of us told our 8-year-old selves that we'd be in the position that we'd be in right now, then none of us would believe us.
I don't think there's a single aspect of what I belong to here and what I'm able to do here that could be possibly any better anywhere in the country.
The family here is different than other places. The camaraderie that's built in this locker room is pretty special.
Push-ups!
I think what you see these relationships that form, you know, that become life relationships. I think everybody that does come here and puts a lot into what this place is about, you know, gets a lot more than just a sort of a standard lacrosse experience.
It's not necessarily how smart you are, it's how hard you're willing to work.
What does ILPL mean?
Yeah, I love Penn Lacrosse.
I love Penn Lacrosse, of course. Stand by it.
The dream of college lacrosse comes down to one word. Love. Love of the sport. Love of who it makes athletes become. And love of what we can accomplish as a team.
So after every win, we play Murder on the Dance Floor and just it's a huge mosh pit and everyone just goes crazy.
It's every single time after we get a win, we all pile up in the locker room and we blast that song to the max. And
that'll be a song that I will never forget. It's going to be played at my wedding.